reproductive health. What is meant by reproductive health? It is nothing but having very healthy reproductive organs. That means reproductive health means having healthy reproductive organs without any defects. But WHO, that is World Health Organization, has defined the reproductive health as the complete social, physical, mental well-being of the particular humans. Then we call them as reproductive health. Okay, what is meant by the social well-being? Social well-being of any human beings means we are socially very well behaved with other human beings. That means when we go outside from our house, our neighbors will be there. If they come and say, how are you, what are you doing, then we should be able to reply in the same very good manner. If you are not replying properly, then how are you means wife are you, why do you bother about our lives? If you say like that, that means you are mentally illness. That means you have the psycho problems also. So World Health Organization says that the reproductive health means not only all those things but also the social well-being with your neighbors and other co-human beings who are existing in the society. Then what is meant by physical health? Physical well-being. Physical well-being means we should be physically fit. Physically fit not only in appearance, that means they are not only in the appearance having two hands, legs and all other organs well, that means not handicapped. Okay, so that we call it as physically well. Then what is mental? Mental well-being means even you should be able to communicate well. If we are able to ask some questions, then you should answer in the same module. Answer should also come to that answer question perfectly. If I take a class and ask you, you are in which class, means if I am talking about 12th class or intermediate second year, if you say I am in 8th class, then what is that? It is mental illness. So World Health Organization says that the complete reproductive health of any human beings is the physical, mental and social well-being. Now let us discuss in detail about the reproductive health. See, reproductive health, what are the components? The overpopulation, early age of marriage are the two components which are causing lot of effect on this particular reproductive health. What is overpopulation? Overpopulation is a big crisis in case of India. In India, we all know that in the complete world, China is standing number one in overpopulation. Next is India. So this overpopulation right from the ages, that means before independence also, even till today, we are not able to control the overpopulation. What will happen if a country is highly overpopulated? What will happen? Then the resources, whatever which are there, they are not supplied equally to all the populations. Now consider a small family consisting of four members in a family, father, mother and two children. Father, mother and two children. Whatever income that is coming to this particular family will be sufficient, or it will be somewhat they can enjoy nicely the comforts and pleasures which are provided by the, which are there in the society. But if you consider the same small family as if they have some 6 to 10 children and having same income of that particular whatever budget they are getting, then it is overcrowded. So in the same way, you assume this to the nation, what will happen? The government cannot provide the resources equally to the highly populated people in the country. So overpopulation is always a big problem for the society. Overpopulation is causing lot of problem to the nation's per capita income also. Now coming to the early age of marriage, what will happen if the marriage age is very early? What will happen? So what will happen when the age of marriage is very early means the maternal mortality rate increases. The maternal mortality rate, it increases, and infant mortality rate, what will happen? It will decrease. That means the maternal mortality rate, that means when you are performing the marriages, childhood marriages are not encouraged. Why? Because the reproductive system of both the male and the female will not be developed properly, and hence what will happen, the particular uterus which has to maintain this pregnancy and all, it will be very, the mother is very young, so the hormones will also be not secreted properly, and thus the infant mortality rate will also increase. So coming to the early age marriages, what are the deformities in the children? So when you perform, even though when you perform the early marriages, what will happen? The children will be born, but most of the children, infants means immediately after the birth, 0 to 2 years or 0 to 1 year, we can say they are the infants. So they will immediately, they die due to so many reasons. And if at all those infants are sustaining, that means if they persist to some age, what will happen? Deformities in the children will occur. Deformities, there may be number of deformities like eye deformity, hearing deformity, leg abnormalities, hand abnormalities. Mentally their children will not be developing the brains. So many deformities will be seen in the children. Now next is the STD. What is STD means? Sexually transmitted diseases. Sexually transmitted diseases will be very much, these STDs are very high in India. So sexually transmitted diseases, this we can see especially in the young group of children which belongs to 13 to 24 years of age. 13 to 24 years of age children are usually suffering from sexually transmitted diseases. We will look into what is all those things. Okay, first you follow that. These are all the different aspects of the reproductive health. Now, how to control? Now, how to control all these things? The control measures for all these things is, the primary thing is, there should be education. If the children is having very good education, then the reproductive health problems will not occur. So, always the government of India will encourage the people, all the citizens, to be educated. If once they take this education, they will know what is good and what is bad, what kind of hormones are being secreted in our body, and what is happening inside our body. All these things will be told in the process of education, and this is the first primary control measure. Number two is the family planning. Family planning is very, very important. The family planning in the form of contraceptives, so many contraceptive methods are there in so that also been adapted and also been given by so many things from the central government and also the state government in India. So, and the how to control this, all these things, is the third one, is the law. A very perfect law has been enacted by the government of India is that 18 years of marriage for the females. For females, the right age of marriage, that means the correct, when they have to perform the marriage, starting age will be 18, and 21 for the male. Female's age must be 18 and 21 for the male. So this is the law. If anybody performs child marriages below 18 for the girl or below 21 for a boy, then it is punishable. It's a criminal case also. They punish them. So these are all the control measures. First one is education, next is family planning through contraceptives, third is the law which is given by the government, 18 for the female, 21 for the male.